Get your special horoscope for the year ahead 2020 at NadiaShaw.com. Hello, fabulous superstar Libra. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of January 2020. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. And it is one of these truly powerful moments because there is a lot of power in the sky right now. Part of the reason is the lunar eclipse. Right around the 10th of the month, the lunar eclipse will be taking place at the very top of your sky. This is a part of the sky connected to career, social standing, life purpose, the goals you have for your life. This eclipse is standing across the sky from a conglomerate of planets, as I'm calling it. It is Pluto and Saturn meeting in the sky that's been getting a lot of attention for the last few years, really. Now, this meeting is happening at the very foundation of your chart, the bottom of your sky, having to do with home and family of origin and the things that you're working on in your own time and in your own space. It has to do with your understanding of your past as well. Well, it isn't just about these two planets, but the Sun and Mercury will be there with Saturn and Pluto, which adds heat and energy and thoughts and conversations. So imagine we have this, what I'm calling a conglomerate, really it's a stellium of planets at the very foundation of your chart, and they are standing across the sky from one of the more visible parts, if not the most visible part of your chart. Now, this speaks to a few different things. I do think that this could be a time when you are making moves and making big changes where it comes to your career, where it comes to your understanding of what it is you're meant to do, where it comes to your life purpose. For some, these changes are going to flow easier than they might for others. In fact, I would say for some out there of your sign, this can be a time that feels challenging. When you really are examining yourself much more deeply and realizing where the past has brought you to where you are today and how you really feel about it and what works for you and what isn't, where it is that perhaps you were operating from, whether it was your earliest childhood messages or whether it was some pain that you experienced in the past, and how that has contributed to what it is that you allowed yourself to go for now. Now, regardless, the key here to remember is that you are transforming your understanding of your direction and what really matters. And this is nothing less than your destiny. In fact, there are some Libras out there who might feel as if they've glimpsed a different future for themselves. And they've had a different vision and they realize they're ready to travel new pathways. There might be some Libras out there who feel like their family of origin, perhaps your parents, it is possible where you feel that there isn't the support there to do what it is that you desire to do on a career front. Now, regardless of how this energy plays out for you, the key to remember here is that the universe has been working overtime for the last year and a half, trying to align a sense of what your goals are with what could be a higher, more loving vision for your life, trying to help you to understand success differently and root it in personal principles of authenticity. And where it is that you continue in alignment with that, this can be a time of breakthrough. But where it is that maybe you are not so much in alignment with that, this can be a time of tremendous change. Now, for others out there, it is possible that a boss may leave. It might be under the guise of a lot of drama, okay? There might be a lot going on underneath the surface. For other Libras out there, though, this is an energy that's going to hit a lot more personally and be a lot more about you and your understanding of where it is that you are ready to change course. Regardless, you are being aligned with something beautiful and something better than you knew before. There might be strong emotions as part of this alignment, or there may be some external people behaving dramatically as part of this alignment, but it's all helping you to move towards a more empowered direction. Now, as we move later into the month, right around the 24th is when we are going to have a new moon. This new moon is taking place in a part of the sky for you That has to do with creativity. It has to do with the children in your life. It is also connected to fun and trusting your passion. It is also connected to romance as well. So I'll talk about love in just a moment, but here are some key interesting things about this new moon. It will be speaking with Uranus in a conversation of tension. This very tension is one of surprise and one of whether it's information for you, new opportunities seem to come out of nowhere. So if there are children in your life, this is where they may behave rebelliously. This is where some of the more rebellious tendencies that can happen with children does come forward. It is also possible at this time that you are feeling especially creative, or if it is that you are a person who uses your creativity to your advantage, you may feel as if you're getting some feedback or some insight that lends itself to mixed feelings on your part. It could be also that you might be seeking funding as part of your creative expression, and it may feel like there's some challenges navigating that process. I would also add with this part of the sky having to do with fun. Well, look, fun can turn very serious right about now. It is Uranus in a part of the sky that has to do with, on the one hand, funding, which is why I just mentioned funding and creativity. But it is also connected to digging really deep and the transformative process, the transformative journey. And so it may be something that seems very fun on the surface that ends up reaching very deeply within you, serving as a catalyst moment. Now, I would also add, if it is that you're planning to have fun right about now, you might be planning to hit the town or live it up in some way. Well, look, this is you being very surprised by how quickly charges can rack up. So keep that in mind. Enjoy your life, of course, but you know how they say, like, the best things in life are free? You'd be amazed that if you're willing to find them and look for them, they are all around you, those free and wonderful things. Now, where it comes to matters of love, yes, this is a part of the sky connected to flirtation and romance. This new moon will be speaking in harmony with Chiron in your opposite sign, which speaks to partnerships of all kinds. Now, I just love this connection for you. In the first half of the month, Venus is moving through this part of the sky as well. So just as Venus leaves, a few days later, about 10 days later, you've got the new moon here, bringing you more romantic energy and supporting love, connecting to the bigger picture. So there's a lot going on here. If you are open to meeting someone new, a flirtation may come very much by surprise, if not shock. It may represent something taboo about it as well. Again, that's the placement of Uranus speaking with this new moon. But for all that, and for most of the month, especially with Venus as well and the beautiful energy there, the supportive energy of Chiron to the new moon, it does look like you may be connecting with people in a very organic way, having flirtations that remind you that there are options available to you where it comes to matters of love. For those of you who are just starting to date somebody, this can be very interesting energy. In the first half of the month with Venus here, it just tends to be really nice and fun as you are dating someone. With the new moon though, this person may act in ways that feel kind of erratic, that feel like they've kind of come out of nowhere, and may leave you with some mixed feelings. The great thing is though, if you're willing to talk to this person, relate to this person, you may be able to reach a new understanding with them. For those of you who are in an established bond, I do think that Chiron becomes that much stronger in established partnerships and can fuel an understanding of the love that the two of you share, and possibly even be part of at least one romantic and also very healing moment that can transpire now. But for all that, it can be right now that a part of what's happening in your established bond is connected to what's happening with your partner's income. So there might be a little bit of fluctuation or surprise connected to your partner's income that in turn speaks to maybe what romantic moments are possible or maybe not possible. Now, this just represents a moment. So that's the thing to remember. For the most part, throughout this month, in one way or another, you have beautifully romantic energy supporting the love that the two of you share. And if something should come up, It could be something as simple as you're out on a date and your partner's credit card is maxed out, so you might have to step in. So just be mindful of that. The love that the two of you have, you can continue to emphasize in ways that don't necessarily have to do with going all out, but have to do with the connection that the two of you share. When you focus on the connection, you bring more of that healing, beautiful energy of Chiron into the love you have. What I love about this month for you, well, there's a lot here, but I am going to say the eclipse, actually. I know that's not an easy energy for a lot of people out there. Emotions will be running strong. And for you, where it is that there's something you really want to achieve, that you've got your heart and mind set on bringing to fruition, well, to have things go in unexpected directions or to feel as if there are factors larger beyond your control, it isn't always fun. However, this time is honest. This time is ultimately meant to show you something about all that you could be and all that you could achieve. I learned a long time ago, delays are not denials. Delays are never denials. Now, whether it's a delay or whether it is the fulfillment of something that was delayed, there are real reasons to celebrate now, real reasons that say you are on an accelerated pathway towards greater success than you've known before. Well, thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for the 2020 preview horoscope for your sign coming right up. And you can get a video like this every week by logging on to NadiaShaw.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded exclusive video scopes each and every week. Unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy. Hello, fabulous superstar Libra. Welcome to your horoscope for the year of 2020. This is your special horoscope. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. What an amazing year it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. And this year has some truly big events taking place. If we had one of these, maybe two of these, that would be a big deal. But there's just so much happening now, ushering us into a brand new decade. So I'm going to touch on a few themes that I think are going to be especially important for you. And for you, I want to start with what is happening with Mars. This is a Mars retrograde season year. So it is going to be towards the end of July that Mars will step into shadow. In the first part of September, we'll go retrograde and stay retrograde right to the middle of November, and then go direct and stay in shadow right to the very beginning of January 2021.